Veronica Sevilla, General Manager of the Tourism Board of Quito.
Yeah, well, good afternoon and thank you very much for joining Breaking Travel News. We're coming to the end of World Travel Market 2018 here in London. Just tell me, how important is it for you to be here to connect with your partners from the hospitality industry?
Well, it is very important as a destination to be here to show you the news about the destination, to show the new brand of the city and the new digital platform and the way we are promoting the city on the digital world. That is it's very innovative and it's an innovation of the city, and to support our partners. So World Travel Market is one of the most important tourism fair in the world. I don't know if it would be the first one, I think, and that is a must. So you have to be here and to show all the news that the city has and also the country.
Plenty of headlines from the show, as you mentioned. You've recently unveiled your new branding strategy. What can you tell us about that?
Well, the new branding strategy responds to the need of the market. So the market has changed a lot in the last 10 years, and our former brand had like 15 years, and the city already has changed also in these 15 years. So what is the new traveler? The new traveler is more active, younger, wants to be supported by digital tools, want to give back to the destination, want sustainable tourism. And so that has been introducing the new brand of the city and show a fresh brand, a younger brand that will go to the new markets that are traveling a lot, like the millennials and people that are younger.
And what would you be keen to showcase for people who might not have been to Quito, might not know that much about what's on offer there? It's a cultural destination, it's an ecological destination. What are the key attributes?
Well, we made a very important marketing research last year, and that showed us that we have like five competitive advantages, very, very strong ones: culture and nature and adventure, and also the gastronomy, and also the kindness of our people. So those five competitive advantages has been power in everything that we are communicating right now. And of course, it goes along with the new trends that new travelers are looking for. So we are a match.
It's easier than ever to get to the destination as well. I believe you're bringing new flights in from Europe as well.
Exactly. One of the bases and the tip ones of the new strategy is connectivity. And with that, we are bringing new airlines also, like June, that is flying from Paris on May, the Iberia, that has enhanced to 7 flights a week. We also have a connection through Aeromexico that is also for US and Asia. So it is like they have already like 11 flights a week. We also have LATAM. LATAM has increased its connection to Santiago with 3 flights a week. Last week they just launched that. And we're working very hard. In December, we're going to have a direct flight from São Paulo 5 times a week. So we're working very hard on the connectivity. And of course, it's working because you have to have the way to get the people easily and friendly to the destination. And that's something that we're working very hard.
You mentioned other Latin American destinations there. How important is interregional travel? Do you welcome a lot of guests from across the region?
Well, we have a lot of guests from across the region, and we have, you know, the immediate market, the mid-term market, and the long-term markets. So the just on time market would be like Colombia and Peru or neighbors countries, and then you have Latin America and U.S., and then you have Europe, and on the long haul, you have Asia. And that responds to the advance. With the advance, they book their trips. So you have to apply different strategies because, for example, Latin American, they can decide in a week or next day to travel. And for example, in UK, it has gone a little bit shorter, but it's like 6 months at least when you travel. So you have to make the promotion thinking to have results at least on 6 months or 2 years. So it depends on the market. So you apply different strategies to different markets.
Yeah, certainly very interesting. On the business side as well, new convention center coming onto the market soon as well. That's going to be a real asset for the city.
Yeah, it is. It is already open. We are not. We opened the fair. The fair infrastructure, because the Congress infrastructure is still being top up with some infrastructure that it has to have, but it will open on March. completely integrated with full equipment. And that is something that we needed because we have only infrastructure for congresses until 500 people. Now we can receive 3,000, for example, in a very comfortable and top of the line congress center. So that makes us that puts us on the market with a high standard accommodation. Yeah.
And I believe congratulations are in order as well, recognized by the World Travel Awards. Those are voted for by members of the public and members of the hospitality industry, so a very prestigious title. How does it feel to have won that?
Well, we are very proud to have won that, and it's a very hard work. It is not easy to get one of those prizes. We really think that's a recognition for the city, and it also gives you a higher standard. So you every time that you win one of those, you have to be better. So we consider that a recognition, but we don't dream, we don't sleep on it. Every time that we get one, we think, okay, this is a responsibility, we have to be better. So the next year we get the other one. That's why we had 6 years in a row the leadership as South America's leading destination. Last year and this year we got the Congress leading destination. And this year with a new one that is the cultural city destination, yeah.
Well, congratulations, and I appreciate you taking a few moments to speak to us today. Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much, and of course, we are always open to come to UK, and we, of course, want to have always Quito in the mind of European people, yeah.